Hi guys, it's me, Clog, the resident chimney sweeping child molester of the sector. For years, I've been mocked, bullied, and ridiculed for being poor and irrelevant. But soon they'll see, they'll all see, that I can make waves in the toilet bowl of the sector! I, Clog, have heard rumors of a glorious treasure, a mythological treasure of such grandeur and opulence that can scarcely be imagined at the Grimsby Chip and Brief this day! I have tracked this treasure down for thousands of miles of jungle track, and soon it shall be mine! Clog News Factually Accurate Alert from the Amazonian jungles. Situation has become dire. Very shambolic out here. There's not a single fucking Hugo Boss out there. There's no Greggs, no Witherspoons, Prospect's four-piece KFC non-fucking-existent. It's got real bad. Fortnight ago, I was forced to eat the poo wife for sustenance. It's grim, but we gotta press on. We gotta find the fabled, mythological, lost treasure of Grimsby. We're in the deepest, darkest fucking jungle. But thankfully, I still have me Pokemon Dan. And we will find the treasure and own the casino. You best believe it's factually accurate. I'm gonna make waves in the tractor toilet bowl. You will see. You'll so see. Guys, it's a Clog. Factually accurate. News update from the jungle of the Amazon. Unfortunately, me best mate Dan, I sent him me Pokemon Dan to fight a jaguar. He was eaten. Dan was eaten. And I'm all alone in the jungle. How are we gonna own the casino now? I gotta find the treasure. We gotta find the treasure. Otherwise I'll never have another 3p for 50 chippy at the Grimsby Chippy. Hey guys, it's another Clog Live factually accurate update from the jungles of the Amazon. I've been wandering in circles for days. There's no more poo wife, no more Pokemon Dan. Starting to lose hope, starting to believe we'll never find the lost treasure. Wait, could it be? Oh, blimey! It's not possible, could it be? It's fabulous! It's beautiful! It's like nothing I've ever seen before in my life! Oh my God, it's beautiful! But could the treasures be... could the tales be true of this treasure? Could it be true? Oh my goodness! Oh my... oh my days! Oh my days! It's beautiful! I'm rich! I'm rich! Yes, take that, Casino Bros! We've found the fabulous lost treasure of Grimsby! It's a flushable toilet! Yes, it is I, Clog! I have ascended unto my porcelain throne! That's right! I'm now the richest man in all the sector! I have a working flush toilet! I have ascended to mythological levels of wealth never heard of before in Grimsby! That's right! And now it's time to have a laugh with Clog! Are you ready to have a laugh? It's all about having a laugh, isn't it?
It's really Harry, dude. Phil has three bathrooms. Are you telling me this because you were told this off PPP? Harry, get the fucking chat. Stop being a spaz. Learn. Think for yourself, Harry. Oh, no time for Keno Casino audience. They're so stupid. Oh, I heard he's got three toilets. Did you hear that from PPP? He also says here that he has two. So he's got two and he's got three. But also, PPP needs you to go and buy him one. So what's this about? What's this about, Harry?
Level, please.
What's this about, Harry?
This is like cog level, please.
Buy him a toilet.
We gotta get Phil a working toilet.
You gotta get Phil a working toilet, Harry. But then, PPP's gonna tell you he's got two working toilets. And then on this show, he's got three, Harry. Again, if you're not a retard, I don't yell at you. If you're a retard, I'm yelling. I'm hoping it gets through that fucking 2-inch thick skull you've got to that fucking 1-inch diameter brain that you've got. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping it gets through. That's why I yell. With all of my chat, I can be quite normal with the...
Talking about having a laugh there, Clog. Holy shit there, buddy. The man is just spazzing. Hey, spazzing for months about toilets. Harry, how can the toilet, Harry? Don't be such a spaz, Harry, as he's spazzing the fuck out. Losing his mind about whether somebody has a toilet or not. The mental illness is fucking unhinged. But for clarification there, buddy Cog, Phil had three working toilets. Then one of the toilets stopped working, Cog. Then there were two working toilets, Cog. You follow? The clip that you were playing there where I said we need to get him a working toilet so he's not Cog level. I thought he only had one toilet that wasn't working, Cog. But in fact, there were three toilets. One wasn't working, leading to two working toilets. The fact we even are discussing this shit, he's losing his fucking mind. That means that with two working toilets, he has infinitely more toilets than you, Cog. It's not that hard to understand, bro. It's not that hard, bro. But he's screaming at Harry Morris, a guy who was one of his top donors. The thing is, I don't even think it was the real fucking Harry. It wasn't even the real fucking Harry. So he's yelling at one of his top donors for no fucking reason, like a psychopath there. Maybe it's because Harry hasn't been chipping in as of, I don't know, Cog. But like, the state of the sector, man. Like, are you gonna be okay? Does your toilet work, bro? Did you finally get one? Or are you still using that filthy old poo bucket? The wife straining the KFC corn out, Cog. Tough look there, bud. Right, now we're coming at you with a factually accurate alert. Remember, folks, Cog, the diddler of Dudley, the pedophile who did nonce the 14-year-old according to his own brothers, his own blood there. He prides himself on being factually accurate. Everything he says is factually accurate. But here, we're going to see some dishonest editing from Cog. That's right. Cog's not actually factually accurate. He's factually inaccurate, isn't it? Take a look. Here's the original unaltered clip.
There's 2,991 people watching this show.
Now let's watch Cog's factually inaccurate butcher job of the facts and the truth.
91 people watching this show.
There are 91 people watching your show? That's pretty depressing, bro. That sounds like you're getting less than what I get on average.
Cog gets about 20 viewers.
Yeah.
Right?
What? 64 people watch? What are you talking about? We get about 100 people watching typically. This is like early morning, though. This is 2:45 in the afternoon for me. What time is it for the US then? So that's 9 a.m. for Central Time, let alone if you're on the East Coast and stuff like that. And then if you go over to the West Coast, it gets even worse.
Well, we see here the mental illness of Cog there on full display. Just total denial of reality. Like Ministry of Truth, Mini Truth level propaganda and delusion from Cog. In the original clip, I claim, because it's factually accurate, that we have 2,991 viewers. Nearly 3,000 viewers. Which isn't crazy for us. We do anywhere between 2,000 and 4,500, like when we get Josh or Phil on or some shit. Okay? Cog takes that, claims that we only get 91 viewers. I don't know if he does admit it makes him feel better about himself. If he thinks he's actually fooling people. Like, is he trying to fool himself with this delusion? And then when I say he has 20 viewers, he's like, huh! I actually have 60-something viewers. Cog, it's more factually accurate there to say that we have 3,000, bud. Holy shit. Oi, how can you say that? It's far closer, more factually accurate for me to say that you have 20 and you actually have 61 than for you to say I have 91 when I have 3,000, Cog. It's just sad, buddy. It's pathetic there. But this is the insane mindset of Cog. The lengths that he'll go to just deny the truth and live in a fantasy land of his own delusions. But what can we expect from the Dudley Diddler, whose own brothers say he's a dirty nonce pedophile? It's tough out there for Cog, folks. But I don't want to hear another word. Factually accurate this. The casino's not factually. When Cog edited the clip to try and shave 2,900 viewers away from the casino there. Shame on you, Cog. It's not factually accurate, innit? The final clip today is going to show Cog's casino derangement syndrome. His bitterness, his jealousy. All of it is delusions on full display. Check it in there.
It's insane. Like, I can't understand the insanity that is the Keno Casino audience. But again, all I can do is point out this constant, like disconnect that they have from reality, where it's like, if it's Keno Casino, that, like, literally right now, Keno Casino could rape a child on their show and they wouldn't criticize it. That's how fucked up their audience is, right? I'd be sat there going, bro, that's fucking that's like, arrest that shit. None of them. They'd be sat there going, oh my God. If I sat there and did a show going, have you seen how disgusting this is? And block all everything, but just listen to what's being said. Oh, wow. Cog's promoting child porn. That's what it would be. That's how insane this is.
Folks, what can you even say? Cog is the diddler of Dudley. Cog was accused by his own brothers. His own flesh and blood brothers of molesting a 14-year-old when he was in his 30s. Okay. He's an actual diddler. Like an actual nonce that acted out on it in real life. He's coming up with weird fantasies there about us diddling when he's the diddler. And he's like, why don't people love me? Why don't people believe me? Why don't they hate the casino? And Cog, it's really simple, brother. You're bitter. You're boring. You're not funny. And you're seething, man. You're always seething. All of this comes from a place of jealousy and anger that you didn't get on our show and promoted enough, or Josh's show, or Medicare's show, or whatever the fuck. How about, Cog, you actually do a good show? Or maybe just get the fuck off the internet. Maybe turn yourself into the police. Get some help for your fucking diddling habits there, your mental illness. It's very sad, bro. It's pathetic there. Well, that's it. That's it for Toilet Tales with Clog. Are we gonna flush that shit now? The old Clog. A working toilet, something you'll never have.